Are certain body types better suited to certain sports? Hello everybody, this is Dr. Fox from the Fox Power Basement.
Please like and subscribe.
People are born with an inherited body type or somatotype based on skeletal frame and body composition. Ectomorphs are long and lean, with little body fat and little muscle. They have a hard time gaining weight. Endomorphs have lots of body fat, lots of muscle, and gain weight easily. Mesomorphs are athletic, solid and strong. They carry a lot of muscle and can both gain and lose weight without too much effort. Everyone falls, though not altogether neatly, into three categories of body types. Of course, these are generalizations, and most of us have characteristics of two or even all three somatotypes. Classic combination somatotypes include pear-shaped ectoendomorphs with thin, delicate upper bodies and high fat storage in the hips and thighs, and apple-shaped endoectomorphs with high fat storage in the midsection and thin lower bodies. During the next few minutes, I will put up some very nice images published November 2013 in the Daily Mail, showing the incredible range of shapes and sizes as 125 of the world's most finely tuned athletes measure up against each other. I will put the link to the article in the description. Generally, most people are mixtures of body types, but those who are mesomorphic tend to do well in sports such as weightlifting, while running is where ectomorphs are found to excel. Research shows that some people's muscles have a greater capacity to deliver big bursts of energy for short periods, while others are better at delivering a smaller amount of steady power over a sustained period. The former group are adapted to power events, and the latter are better suited to endurance sports. Muscles are made up of two different types of fibers. The slow twitch fibers deliver prolonged contraction over many minutes or hours, favoring endurance events. The fast twitch fibers deliver extreme amounts of power for a few seconds, favoring sprint events or those requiring sudden power, such as weightlifting. The ratio of fast to slow fibers in each person is genetic. Marathon runners tend to be light and lean, and gold medal powerlifters are solid blocks of muscle with short arms and legs. A 1.5 meter guy has little chance of becoming an elite basketball player, but being 2 meters with the springiest tendons in the land doesn't automatically propel you to Olympic gold. Unless you have tactical sense where needed, access to decent equipment, medical backup and the optimum psychological conditions for a winning attitude, and be able to power yourself through pain and, of course, superb technique, all the physical attributes will be in vain. But still, having the right physique for the right sport is a great starting point. There is also a race issue. African origin competitors hold the majority of leading times for top running events, even though only 1/8 of the world population is black. And the Kalenjin tribe from Kenya holds 40% of the world-class medals for distance running. These Kenyan people tend to have slim legs, with a genetic trait of high calf muscles, which is an efficient anatomy for a runner. They also live above 2000 feet, which helps to increase the body's amount of red blood cells and its cardiovascular capacity, which are both vital for distance running. Research shows that an ideal 100 meter sprinter is tall, with a strong mesomorphic body shape, with a high percentage of fast twitch fibers, more than 80%. Top sprinters have slim lower legs and relatively narrow hips, which gives a biomechanical advantage. They are able to use muscle fuel so fast that they are basically running on fumes by the end of the race. The perfect weightlifter is well-muscled with a strong mesomorphic body type. Not tall. Good weightlifters tend to have relatively short arms and legs, which makes them more efficient levers. Their cardiovascular systems are able to stand sudden surges in blood pressure and have high percentage of fast twitch fibers. Although it seems certain body types are better suited to certain sports, there is still a considerable degree of you are what you train for. The more recent research into sporting genes could have even greater implications than body type in terms of determining who can be good at certain sports and who will be made better at a sport. And don't forget, numerous sports exist where your body shape will be suited no matter what it is. Some of the most famous sports have become popular because of the fact that so many shapes and sizes are able to take part. Prime examples are soccer, football and rugby. Other sports, such as windsurfing, archery and cycling, are other known examples. Where it is your concentration, dedication and strength, rather than shape, that matters most.
I hope you enjoyed this video.
Please like and subscribe.